Don't just think me, I know. I saw. I'm intelligent. I'm sharp. Ask Allah to help you to use that intelligence in the right direction. Today, you can see a video. It looks so real, but it's false and fake. Ask Allah to show you the truth and to help you to walk on the true path. How I always used to tell myself as I grew up, that if a Hollywood movie looks so real that people cry when they watch the movie, yet it's false. No one died there. Right? And people cry. You follow a soap, subhanAllah. And what is that soap doing? It makes you connected to it such that you really think these people just happened to them. Nothing of that nature happened to even one of them in their real lives. What did they do? They created a movie that looked so real that you were changed in emotion. SubhanAllah. You tell your friends, did you see what happened? The next episode, I'm waiting because you know this guy might end up dying and so on. That's how it used to be. Can I tell you, we are now 20, 30 years later. People can do the same thing on their phones. And you're watching the movie, say, Astaghfirullah. But nothing happened. They created this. It was false. We are living in an age, the Prophet ﷺ said, there will come a time close to Qiyamah when the truth will appear to be false and falsehood will appear to be true. That's where the dua comes in. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqa warzuqna tiba'ah wa arina al-batila batila warzuqna jitinabah. Oh Allah, show the truth to us to be true and help us to follow it, and show the false to us to be false and help us to stay away from it. That's a powerful dua. What else did the Prophet ﷺ used to say? All of us are mu'mineen. May Allah accept it from us. We are all believers. If I ask you, are you a believer? You say, yes, that's why I'm in the house of Allah. We're all believers. May Allah accept it from us. But I want to tell you something. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, used to make a dua. One of the duas I started this talk with. Allahumma habbib ilayna al-iman. Allahumma habbib ilayna al-iman. Oh Allah, beautify for me iman, make it loved for me, endear it to me. What is it, iman? What is iman? My faith, my belief, my conviction in you, O Allah. My faith in you, make it beautified. Habib ilayna al-iman to us. Wazayyinhu fi qulubina, and beautify it in our hearts. Let the iman be beautiful in our hearts. My brothers and sisters, the diseases of today are all connected to the heart. Dirty, unclean heart, your entire life is struggling as a result, but you don't know. You got your motor vehicle. You ask the mechanic, my car is jerking. What will he tell you? He said, you know, the fuel, probably your fuel filter and so on and so on. If that filter is not correct and you have not filtered out the dirt and whatever else it may be, no matter what vehicle you have, your car is not going to operate because the filter is the problem. You must filter out things. Your heart is your filter. Filter out what needs to be filtered out. The dirt, the dust, the desires, the lusts that will displease Allah need to come out of that. That is a lifelong challenge. It's not just one day, I have a clean heart, mashallah, and you walk out. How old are you? 30, 40. Subhanallah. You say you have a clean heart, you're happy and you're walking out. That heart is going to be attacked with dirt and dust every day by shaitan. Cleaning your heart is a lifelong process. Even close to your deathbed, you are going to have to continue cleaning your heart. Shaitan attacks you every single day. If you don't know how shaitan attacked you today, you are going to need help to find out how he came to you. Don't think, you know, I'm pious, I do my salah, and I'm a good person, and that's it. And there's no need for me to worry shaitan. Now he's tired of me, he's not going to come. No way! You're not a prophet of Allah. If Umar ibn al-Khattabi radiallahu anhu used to be concerned whether he was a hypocrite or not, he used to be bothered about hypocrisy, to say, I pray that I'm not from amongst them. Who's you and I? We are nobodies. There's no even chance our names can even be mentioned close to those names. And we are satisfied, my brothers, my sisters. Allah wa inna fil jasadi la mudgha. Idha salahat salah al jasadu kulluhu. Wa idha fasadat fasad al jasadu kulluhu. Allah wa hiya al qalbu. I'm sure we've heard this hadith many times. Behold, in the body there is a piece of flesh. If it is pure and good, the whole body will be pure and good. It's your filter. If it is dirty and filthy, the whole body will be dirty and filthy. Everything is gone. Your mind is gone. Your practice is gone. Your deeds are gone. Everything is gone because that filter is messed completely. What is it? Allah wa hiya al-qalbu. Behold, it is the heart. Cleanse the heart. Ask Allah for guidance. And then walk towards it as best as you can. You know, when you want something in life, you want a job. You want to get married to someone in particular. You want some goodness. You want good health. What do? You desperately ask Allah for what? Worldly things. You know, this is man. When there is a worldly item, we ask with greater desperation than we do when there is something to do with the hereafter. But that's not right. That's why we say, oh Allah, beautify iman in our hearts. Zayyinhu fi qulubina. Wakarrih ilayna al-kufra wal-fusuqa wal-isyan. Oh Allah, make detested to us disbelief in you. Make it detested to us. Make us dislike it so that we don't work towards it and we don't practice it and we stay away from it. Karrih ilayna al-kufra wal-fusuq and sin. Make sin difficult and hated to us. The minute you see, you say, no, not for me. The minute there's a bottle, you're out of there. You can't imagine doing that because you know what? It's not for me. I'm a mu'min. I've said my shahada. I believe in Allah. I'm going to lead a clean life so that I please Allah. That's what it is. I'm going to lead a very clean life. Well, isyan, oh Allah, that which is sin, that which is transgression, oh Allah, keep us away from it. Waj'alna min ar-rashidin, oh Allah, make us from those who are righteous. Oh Allah, make us from those who are righteous. Look at the beautiful dua of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.